Holy shit, I knew that this movie was popular, but I had no idea that it did this well. I missed it during its theatrical run, so once again I'm a little late to the party. But like a wise man, or woman, once said, better late than never. So, this is the third movie directed by John Krasinski, who also stars in it. He's probably best known as Jim from The Office, who, turns out, can grow a mean beard. It's funny, I just kept waiting for him to break the fourth wall and look into the camera, but alas. His character's wife is played by Emily Blunt, and well, I wonder who she had to sleep with to get that role, am I right? And then finally, they have three kids. Sorry, two kids. But don't worry guys, a fourth, or well, a second, third child is on its way. So, we're in this dystopian future where the world has been taken over by some kind of alien creatures that hunt sounds. So, the whole concept, or gimmick, if you will, is the fact that all the characters in this movie have to be quiet in order to survive. And, well, that's basically the whole premise. Which I like. I mean, I'm not sure if it's been done before, maybe it has, but it still feels rather fresh and it just opens up a horror movie to so many possibilities. I mean, usually sound and music, it plays a big role in scary movies. For example, if you see my previous movie where I talked about Ghostland, that movie was loud. Really, they tried to make that movie as scary as possible by making all the sound and music as loud as possible. But if you have a movie where the characters can only survive by actually being quiet, that has a lot of potential. And unfortunately, that's also where my disappointment with this movie starts. See, despite having this original concept, they just don't really do anything with it. Sure, the opening is some of the quietest I've ever seen in a movie, but that doesn't change the fact that whenever there's an action set piece, we're treated to the same generic horror score and sound effects you'd expect from your 13 in a dozen scary movie. Doesn't that kind of defeat the whole purpose? I feel like it's such wasted potential. Like, if you really wanted to impress, how amazing would it have been if you made an actual scary movie without, for example, any music? And that's why this, to me, was such a big disappointment, because with all the hype and praise, I honestly thought that this one was gonna be different. Now, how it turns out, the quietness is just a story element, you know, something that drives the narrative, but it's not part of the actual mechanics of the movie. And that, it really is a shame. I mean, like I said, it's just such a missed opportunity. And believe me, I'm not here to shit on John Krasinski's skill or like talent as a filmmaker. I mean, I personally wouldn't know how to effectively make a movie scary without the use of sound and music. But then again, you know, that would be the challenge. So, hey, there was definitely some good stuff.
Mostly the performances, both John Krasinski and Emily Blunt were pretty great. It's funny how I have literally only seen Blunt in one other movie, and that's Edge of Tomorrow, where I did think she was great as well, don't get me wrong. Besides the performances, I'd say the movie was adequately shot, and there were definitely a few scenes where they managed to successfully create some tension, but I'm afraid that in the end the good doesn't really outweigh the bad.
Don't get me wrong, I mean, I definitely didn't hate this movie. It's just I was mostly just extremely underwhelmed by it. Mostly because of, you know, the wasted potential that I talked about earlier. But besides that, I feel like this movie is just riddled with plot holes. And if plot holes isn't the right term, then maybe like logical inconsistencies or just stuff that didn't make sense. On IMDb, I found a bunch of reviews that would go on and on, you know, like making lists of everything that didn't make sense in this movie. But I personally had a problem with three aspects in particular, which I guess could be considered as spoilers, so you can always skip to this time mark in order to avoid that. Okay? Okay, let's see.
First, as it turns out, the noise you make is cancelled out for the creatures to hunt when it's overridden by a source of consistent, louder noise, as we see when the father and son visit the waterfall. If you know this, then why wouldn't you just move near this waterfall? Or, you know, if that's too much of an inconvenience, why not just create some sort of consistent noise where they currently live? I mean, we know they have all this fancy equipment and a huge source of electricity to do so. Then, in the end, it turns out that the creature's weaknesses are a specific high-frequency tone and a shotgun blast to their unprotected head. And it's like, no fucking shit! I mean, creatures with incredibly highly sensitive hearing, and no one thought about experimenting with this? Also, the army guns? Like, am I just stupid, or... And finally, why get pregnant when the world is overrun by creatures that kill you at the slightest bit of noise? Babies cry a lot. Also, giving birth is, from what I understand, not a completely silent activity for the mother in question either. It's like, did you guys really think this one through?
And so on and so forth. Besides that, I personally wasn't a big fan of the CGI or maybe like the creatures in general. And at one point I felt like they were really forcing this family dynamic subplot between the father and the daughter. And it just felt really forced, you know, just to get that aww moment at the end. In the end, it was okay. It's just, like I said, I was just quite underwhelmed and I just don't really get all the praise it's received. To me, it just felt rather straightforward with your standard like horror genre tropes and set pieces. But what do you guys think? Am I missing something? Am I nitpicking again? Please let me know in the comments. Once again, I'm curious to see your reaction to this one. And that's all for today. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers and have a nice day.